Dear students, now we will be discussing about students with hearing impairment. So, students with hearing impairment can be classified, or a table is shown for hearing impairment, which can be classified into five subgroups like mild, moderate, moderately severe, and profound. So under the category of mild, students with hearing impairment finds difficult to identify soft sound such as whispering. Coming to the moderate, students with hearing impairment are unable to hear clearly what others are saying during conversation. Hearing aids are necessary. Coming to moderately severe, students with hearing impairment finds unable to clearly hear loud noises such as telephone ring. Coming to the severe, students with hearing impairment can only hear very loud noises and sounds such as shouting or vacuum cleaner noise. Coming to profound, students with hearing impairment finds it very difficult, or you can say difficult, to perceive any sound. Coming to the assessment of students with hearing impairment, so there are audiological tests which can be classified into formal and informal types. So under formal, there are two types of tests are being done. First one is subjective test and the second one is objective test. Coming to the informal type, there we can see about parents interview and case history is taken and primary observation of child's response is being taken. So now coming to the auditory assessment. So there are some of the steps we can say about, or stages we can say. So first stage is detection. So at this stage, the teacher checks to see if child is able to distinguish between presence and absence of sound in his or her environment. Ability to detect phonemes, words, phrases, or sentences through listening alone is assessed. Coming to next stage, that is discrimination. The second stage assesses the student's ability to discriminate between different sounds. Again, the student needs to be assessed at level of phonological awareness, word, phrases, and sentences. Coming to the third stage, that is identification. This means checking if the student is able to identify the particular sound, phoneme, word, phrase, or sentence. Coming to the next stage, that is comprehension. This is the highest stage of achievement. Once the child is able to identify the child's ability to understand the meaning of the message heard needs to be assessed. Now coming to the formal hearing test. So all the formal tests make use of instruments which can vary from simple to most sophisticated ones. The tests are characterized by presentation of a sound stimulus such as pure tones, speech, warble tones, and noise. The tests are basically performed by an audiologist, that is tester, on subjects with or without hearing loss. The tests give a result which is again interpreted by the tester. The ultimate goal of each test is to establish the auditory hearing threshold, which is the minimum stimulus level that elicits a response consistently. The instrument used for basic test are audiometer, emittance audiometer, instrument for electrophysiological test such as ABR, that is auditory brainstem response, with software and other accessories. And OAE, that is again auto acoustic emissions instruments. These tests can be used for screening, diagnostic purposes, and school screening programs. Now coming to the subjective tests. So these tests need participation of the subject. The participation can be active or passive. In this test, the response is recorded after the presentation of a stimulus. The response can be predefined active one, for example, raising hand in response to a sound stimulus, or it can be changed in behavior of the child, for example, searching for the sound stimulus, which can be noted by the tester. Now coming to the objective tests. These tests need no active participation from the child. The child's state of arousal, cognitive level, or vocabulary does not affect the results of these tests. These tests are time effective and also provide an important tool in the test battery approach. They also help to cross-check the results obtained from subjective tests. The use of these tests give information about functioning of the hearing structures beyond cochlea. These tests give information about type and degree of hearing loss. Many of these are also used for screening purposes in neonatal stage. Moreover, these tests are very important for difficult to test population. For example, children with intellectual impairment, non-cooperative child. Now, coming to the supporting learning of students with hearing impairment. So there are some specific strategies. So first one is combined visual presentation with oral materials. Audio-visual method is very effective teaching method for them. Use of handouts for these children has marvelous effect on them. When necessary, multisensory approach is well applicable. Pupils' attention should be prior factor. Major portion of the lesson should be completed. Presentation of each point should be clear to them. Using transition sentences help them to learn. Short and clear verbalization means a lot to them. Asking questions again and again help them to check comprehension. Explaining and repeating things number of times makes them easy to learn. Now coming to the classroom management. Arranging the seats in front of row of room, preferably on one side, so that they obtain a better view of both teacher and the classmate. Keep the auditory and visual distractors to a minimum. Always remember that environmental noises are also a problem for the child with a hearing aid, since all noises are amplified for the child. Checking the hearing aids regularly to optimize the child's opportunities to speech read, the teacher should try to maintain a distance of about 6 feet between teacher and child, speaking naturally, and follow other principles of speech reading and auditory training. Further on the classroom management, attempt to stand still when talking, because excessive movement adds to the difficulty of speech reading. Should be careful not to turn the teacher's back to the class and talk while writing on the board. New vocabulary should be introduced both orally and writing. Always try to make every effort to use visual aids in the instructional process. should give opportunity to the hearing impaired child to participate in various co-curricular activities in the class depending on child abilities and interest. And use of assistive devices, or we can say assistive technology, is very much important. For example, hearing assistive technology system, HATS, are devices that can help the hearing impaired to communicate with others. It may also hear them called assistive listening devices. HATS can be used with or without hearing aids or cochlear implants to make it easier to hear. So that's all in this video. Thank you.